Hey, right guys, Trishmunch's Joe here, and today we are watching and reacting to episode 16 of One Tree Hill season 5. I watched episode 15 literally yesterday, so it's been not even 24 hours since I watched the last episode, and I was feeling it today. I mean, like, the One Tree Hill always pretty much majority of the time pops out like the go-to show that I'm in the mood for. I don't know why, it just kind of is like I say, a lot of shows I kind of just film on the day, but I think One Tree Hill, like, as I'm recording this, I'm like 3 weeks ahead of when this will be going up on Patreon anyway. I don't know how this has happened. I've just been binging season 5 more so than other seasons, but yeah, I enjoyed the last episode. We had Dan wanting to see Jamie, Jamie wanting to see Dan. We had Deb looking a bit, you know. Then we had that weird scene with Bucko the clown. That was strange but hilarious. So that was good stuff, and yeah, skills. The story was decent and stuff. Like I say, Lucas and Peyton's romance is by far the weakest part of the season for me, but I get it, it's like the main plot point of the. Would you argue that is the main plot of the entire show? What is like the core storyline? Because I'd argue it's anything to do with Dan. He's what puts so much of this show into effect for other characters. But I do think maybe the romance between Payne and Lucas is kind of like the core. It's definitely the core romance. But is it the core storyline? I don't know. I don't know. Maybe there isn't one. Who knows? But yeah, episode 16, guys. If you enjoy, remember to leave a like. If you're new, remember to subscribe. And if you do want the early and uncut reactions to One Tree Hill, then link to the Patreon page will be in the description. And one of the comments down below where they will be a few episodes into season 7 by the time this one's on YouTube. I was about to say, I guess technically like the final third of the entire show. So you can, there you go. There's that. It means nothing because there's still so many seasons to go. But for now, episode 16. Let's do this.
Marvin.
Oh, people on Patreon are defending Mouth now, by the way.
Work hard and
shocked. I would say Mouth's not been as annoying as he has been since the boss slash job storyline. But for me, it's like I don't think his story is good enough for him to have won me back. Karen. When I went back to liking Karen, I felt like a storyline and her character had changed. Then she ruined it again, so there was that. But for me, once a character like Peyton, for example, Peyton's fucked up. It's gonna take a great storyline and for her to be a great character again to fix that. Not like 2 apps of her not being annoying.
I have 6 months to live.
If they kill Dan off, what a mistake that'll be.
He knew in his heart that someday it would return to him.
Do you think the show regretted killing Keith off? What is that? Is he? No, he's not. No, he's not. No, he's not. Oh my
and
god.
His world would be whole
oh
again.
My god. Of course, it's like 3 times the size as Keith. Where did that even come from? Oh, he's so petty. I love him. Oh my god. He's already prepared for it. I can't believe it.
That was from your grandpa, Dan.
Oh, he actually told him. Fair play.
Can I talk to you for a second?
He's dying, Hales.
What?
Dan needs a heart transplant.
No, that was weird. It's like they teleport to a new room.
He's got 6 months to live. Maybe not even that.
Do you believe him? He's not even that old.
Oh yeah, that is true. What if he's faking? Epic prank.
Dan's not spending any time with Jamie.
First, they're putting their foot down on that. I mean, he didn't come back that long ago, to be fair, so yeah. I reckon they'll learn by the end of the season.
You guys are gonna forget something this important? 7 o'clock, right?
Why are you dressed like a robber?
Yeah, 7 p.m. But I appreciate the enthusiasm, Luke.
Wow. Well, that's...
I am kind of nervous about the whole hospital thing.
I like that we're getting scenes with these two. Like I say, even if it is just going to be friends, it'd be weird if they never spoke again.
God, that was like the best night's sleep ever. Luke, hey, what are you doing here?
The music.
He just
look
Angie's
how
pre-op appointment.
Quirky the scene is.
Bye, Luke.
Why was that so weird? Oh, she came out in his shirt, bro. Calm down. It's like an anime character who gets a nosebleed whenever a girl talks to them.
Aren't they silly?
They are pretty silly, Brooke. That's, yeah.
Bring it in.
Yes, Coach Lucas, my favorite Lucas.
So as you can all see, Q's out for 6 weeks.
It's not been 6 weeks yet.
Q, where you going?
Ain't nothing here for me now, man.
Oh my god, get a grip, bro.
Hey, Q, you can't just quit.
Don't do a mouth pity party. Okay, bye. I'm done with you. It's been 16 apps now. I gave you a chance.
Look what we got. More squash and peas. Yummy.
Bro, baby food is vile.
Angie's scared of her creepy Aunt Peyton, isn't she? Yes, we like.
The baby's like, bruh.
Oh, is this girl you might know, Haley James Scott?
Did you hear that, baby girl, Haley James Scott?
You can hear like Hillary's actual accent
be worth a
coming
smile?
Through. I know she's trying to hide it.
Yeah.
But like, she's got an accent there. I don't know if she's trying to like hide it. Oh yeah, he has a job. I forgot Matt has a job.
I need you to do sports for all three.
Yes, damn. Sir.
Yes, sir.
Oh, and Marvin, I heard about your Omaha offer. I think you made the right decision.
What? What Omaha? Do we know about that? Yeah, fair play, Matt. Sure.
It's Dan. He's dying.
Great, he's not.
Right.
I bet it's a fake out. I didn't think about it till Haley said it.
You think he's lying?
Of course he's lying.
Maybe he's not though, because I think them saying he's lying means he probably is not lying.
It couldn't happen to a nicer guy.
Jeez. That's his dad, bro. I mean, like I say, fair, he did kill, like, his dad.
You'll get it back again, trust me.
Why are you just popping up?
That doesn't mean you still won't be a great player. You just have to learn how to play differently.
Trying to give him advice, just popped on in.
Okay, try it again, but slow it down and
stop it.
Dan, I don't care that you're dying, okay? This isn't happening.
Jeez.
We're done here. Nathan, don't hate me because I'm proud of your accomplishments.
I don't think that's why he hates you.
You don't want to live a life of regret. You can have your dream. You just have to really want it.
Stop Jeez,
it.
Yo.
Okay, you don't get it, do you? Just stop
Good dodge, bro.
And leave my family alone.
Dan! You didn't pick your ball up, bro.
Red Bedroom Studios!
Yes,
Red
great.
Bedroom. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Hey, what's going on with you?
Nothing, I'm fine. It's just,
Is she the one who's going to pity Dan?
The studio looks awesome.
So maybe? What if it's Haley who goes to see him?
And so, yeah, it does make me kind of wonder about my real dad sometimes. But,
oh, yeah, I forgot
that you know, then again, what if I meet him yeah. and I don't like him, so...
I bet that'll be a storyline in season 6.
Well, you look healthy.
Come on in, Lucas.
Safe from right here.
Oh, here
Suit
we
yourself.
Go.
But you of all people should take this seriously.
There's nothing wrong with my heart. And if I know you, there's nothing wrong with yours either.
I wish that was true. But I've got the best cardiologist I can buy, and even he can't help me.
The fact he's already got his gravestone.
Calm yourself.
But you're dead to so many of us already, Dan.
Oh, Jesus.
Really, what does it matter?
They're going in on that. He killed Keith. It's not like he like shat on their lawn. You know what I mean? I don't...
Recording studio, making your next record together on your label. It's great that you're really enjoying your work. So
yeah,
much.
These two working together is the storyline. We should have just given Peyton for the whole season, really.
Before the wedding, I told Lucas that he shouldn't marry Lindsay.
It did do that. Yeah.
Sorry if I kept you waiting.
That's alright, random.
Oh. Davis. Clothes, right?
Yes.
I thought you looked familiar.
What?
Which must make you
a friend.
We'll stop her heart and then I'll do the repairs.
Do
you
the
have
repairs?
To stop her heart for how long?
2 hours, maybe longer.
Bro, what?
Extent of her condition.
How do you intend to restart Angie's heart?
After the repairs are complete, we will use an electric shock.
Oh, that's mental. What
the
fuck?
I choice here, but...
That's mad. I've never heard of that before.
A year.
Oh, well.
Maybe two.
Cool.
And then what?
Well, she'll be dead, Brock.
She'll die. I want you to focus on what a great thing it is that you're doing for Angie.
Okay.
Again, I haven't uploaded the episode on Patreon yet, so I don't know. But did I get it right with the baby? Like, the family sends the baby over to America to have the surgery.
Do you happen to know a Dr. Thornton?
I'm pretty sure that's it. Now's the time.
Oh, well, I don't know. Let's see. This thing?
Oh my god, 6 weeks, Quinton.
I'm gonna be ready for the scouts anyway.
Well, then you'll have to learn how to play differently. You have to reinvent your game.
Ah, he's in Dan's.
You gonna throw away everything you ever worked for?
No, I'm not going to. I already did, okay?
Why though, bro? You might.
You know, I punched that dude for you.
I've thrown a lot of punches, and every last one was selfish. Now face it, Q.
Fair enough. Good comeback.
Deal with it.
Yes, Nathan.
These games are so addicting. I just watched a 13-year-old kid from Arkansas. He was pretty upset.
Okay. We're going to keep an eye on that. Station manager's giving me a shot.
Marvin!
Yeah, don't
great.
Fuck it up, bro.
I'm so proud of you, Marvin.
Yes, Maleficent. These two, like, the relationship now. I'm waiting for him to, like, hop to someone else in season six.
Cool. All right. Best thing you ever.
Okay, cool.
I feel like Hayley actually will give it to Dan as well. Hayley's surprisingly the one who seems, not into the idea of getting to know Dan, but, you know, more lenient towards it, I guess.
It made me think I could handle this.
Hey, just remember, you're thinking about that now? A chance to live a full, wonderful life.
They're not going to kill a baby off, surely, in this show. Yeah, I'm going to put down a plus for Brooke and Lucas having scenes.
You suck, you know that.
Yeah, Skills and Jamie. The best bromance.
It's true. Dan's dying. He's out of transplant. He's got 6 months.
Oh, it's actually true. There you go.
I spoke with the cardiologist. In 6 months, Dan's out of our lives once and for all. It couldn't happen to a more deserving guy.
Jeez.
Maybe that makes me the one with the bad heart, but I say, good riddance.
Yeah, you can't be mad at Lucas for that, I guess.
No, 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 not another three, man. What, you scared to go to the hole, little man?
I'm beating
Yeah, but why are you only shooting threes?
Why'd the audio of the game stop?
Said I sucked.
Well, I take it back. You don't suck.
Oh my god. They had the audio of the game and then they just cut it when they start talking. Jesus, that's so weird. What are you staring at? There's no audio! What's going on?
The top seeds in
that was so weird.
With North Carolina's own Blue Devils finding themselves on top of the East.
Tar Heels.
Carolina Tar Heels.
He's fucked it. He's fucked.
Hey, Tiger won the Arnold Hills Invitational.
Who the hell's Arnold Hill?
The Arnold Palmer Invitational.
Oh, mouth, bro. This is like... Oh, Jesus.
That wasn't good, was it?
No, that was horrific.
Over?
Yeah, let's...
He has two more broadcasts. We hurry, I can drop you off and still make it in time. Come on, baby.
Oh, yeah, he's going to have another chance after that.
Without Quentin, we have no inside game. No defense.
Jamie.
Almost all three, huh?
Hey, it wasn't my idea. It was him.
That's a good idea, Jamie. Hey, let's see what that kind of offense we're
going
to
really... Yeah, in theory, that's a good idea.
Well, I have that breakfast meeting at 7:30. Come in.
Why are you here? What?
We need to talk.
No, we don't, Peyton! You literally do not need to talk to her, ever. I was going to be about her dad, maybe. I don't know.
Weird and totally inappropriate of me.
Pretty much.
But I'm kind of here for Lucas and for you.
Peyton, I already told you there's nothing to say.
Please, hear me out.
Lindsay left like 5 times. Oh, she's done with him. She found her excuse.
But in his non-fiction life, he seems very much in love with you.
Oh my
have
God.
You read the book, Peyton? I didn't think so.
I should not even read the
because
book.
Because if you had,
so what you? Sure what have you come here to say then?
It's not me that has to make a decision about Lucas. It's you.
This what a pointless.
Go home, Peyton. Go home and read it.
Exhibition. I've come here to say that the book's not about me, it's about you. It's fiction. I've come here to say that. But I've not read the book, so I don't know what I'm on about. Or what are you on about? Go away, Peyton. You literally...
Left hand, free throws.
Oh, yeah?
You quit the Ravens?
Tell him, Jamie.
I hurt, little man.
I give anything. See him play again. I can tell he wants to.
It's so cute.
Once I've said my piece, I'll go and never come back if that's what you want. Okay, you got 5 minutes.
5 minutes, here we go. Go on, Dan, sell me.
But when I was in prison, I tried to kill myself.
Oh, we're bringing that up.
I broke my neck and I tried to hang myself. Dad, just let me finish.
Damn.
I stepped off that chair.
Actually bringing that up.
I need that piece before I die.
Oh, they're going to kill him all there.
Let me help you with what little time I have left, please.
Oh, he's being genuine. Because we saw that as well, so we know.
Don't deny a dying man's last wish.
He is being a little bit manipulative with it. Like that, don't deny a dying man his last wish. He's like a little bit, you know. But we did see where he was at the end of last season.
I got nervous. I mean, with the bright lights and the teleprompters.
I'm going to put something down as a plus and you lot are going to be shocked when I tell you what it is.
Well, you're my underdog, Marvin.
All right, Maleficent.
20 seconds, McFadden.
Just look at me.
Yeah.
I'll be right behind that teleprompter thingy.
He's gonna smash it now, isn't he?
The Bobcats showed much improvement this year. And today, at their annual...
Oh, yo, easy peasy. Everyone's shook. Excitement about what
lies ahead. So sorry I'm late, everyone. Something sort of came up. Excuse me. Just
here's get right.
We can get started.
Are you sure you're prepared for this meeting, Miss Davis?
Oh, Brooke's always prepared.
Perhaps we should reschedule.
Oh, no, I'm ready to go. I just...
You can't have the baby here, Brooke. Sorry, you can't.
I just need one second.
You can't. Why did you bring it here? What did she think was going to happen?
Oh, you must be looking for Lucas.
No, actually, I was...
Oh, is he come to apologize to Skills?
I owe you an apology.
Yes, Quinton.
Man, you got to know that we look at the big picture.
My God.
What's best for you. And you got to know that we're going to do whatever it takes to get you where you want to be.
Yes, sir.
Oh.
Okay.
Skills.
Hey, Q.
Yes.
Apology accepted, man.
Ah. Okay, but Quentin can't do this again. That has to be it now. They've had him out of a little bit of a Mardy this ep, sure. But we've done three times. So that needs to be the last. We're good now. Let's smash it out. Done.
But we're just shooting threes. Who's going to get us the ball?
Me.
Me.
Meet your new point guard.
Guns blazing.
Sure, Lupus, right,
Ravens on three. I still think there's something missing. And let me tell you what it is.
Baby clothes. Oh.
Angie represents an underserved but lucrative market, and Clothes Over Bros is about to unveil a new line to fit that need.
Baby clothes. Yeah.
Baby Brooke. The future is now.
The future is now. Haven't heard that one before.
Nice work, team.
Okay, that's why she bought the baby, and makes more sense now.
To see what Coach Lucas Scott has up his sleeve to get the Ravens on track. I'm Marvin McFadden, and that's sports.
I'm Marvin McFadden, and you've just been McFaddened. There you go, his dream came true. Or almost. He's getting there.
Second. Nice! Nice job, Q. If you appoint this crazy offense, might just work. Yes!
Job Q, he didn't dunk someone else! That guy got no praise for actually getting it.
I'm gonna work hard, but you need to work hard too, okay?
There you go.
For yourself, for Jamie. Look, you saw something in me before I even saw
Quinton's myself. Changing tune rapid this up.
Maybe this is that.
Watch her take the job.
All you have to do is read right off the teleprompter in front of you.
It's been a plan all along. Will you marry me? He's not proposing already. I say in the big, I love you. Okay, that's...
I love you.
I'll accept it. Marvin. I'll accept it. Good job, Marv. I was going to propose. That's how quick this relationship's moving.
I love you, Millicent Huxtable.
Good job. Good job.
I love you too, Marvin
McFadden. I want no problems with that. Fucking hell, Mouth. Really using that mouth.
Look at that. You wrote your thank you note to Grandpa Dan, huh? Well, let's see what he said.
I'd throw you to Mum and Dad. It's going to be some shit like that, isn't it?
Dear Grandpa Dan,
I want to see the ham rind,
is it? Best birthday ever. I hope you can come in my next birthday and all the worlds after that.
6 months.
James Lucas
12
Scott
months.
Nope. Do you think he'll like it?
Ah, she's going to cave.
I think he's going to love it.
She's going to cave. Nathan, I think we need to have a chat. I think Jamie needs to see Dan. Yeah. They've held out long, though. They held out long. It was just the I'm dying bit that kind of got to it.
But if you need closure with your father, I understand. Just be careful.
Yes, Haley. Everyone's been good this up. Everyone. Pompeian. I've gone to see Lindsay. That scene just did not need to exist. 20 years in the car. Dan Rose leading. MSN. Do you remember? I know that was an MSN, by the way. I just, yeah. Haley, bro! What? What? I thought she was going to actually give it him. Okay, no. Yeah, she's not on... I thought she was going to cave with it. Nathan.
Yeah. Nathan, come in. Our family is the most important thing.
No.
Oh.
I mean my family.
Oh.
And you're not part of it anymore.
Is he not?
That's what I came here to tell you.
What? Oh.
Nathan, please. I'm sorry that you're dying. But you have to know, I can never forgive you.
Oh,
not
bro.
Now, not ever.
They're tripling down.
You made that decision for me the moment you pulled that trigger.
Oh, it hurts to watch. Oh my god. Oh, Dan! I can't even, like, blame Nathan or anyone. Yeah. Yeah. Accept all decline in the video chat. That's how you're gonna end the app. I know, to be fair, it's another like a minute left. Decline. It's getting a bit weird now, Lucas. You gotta stop, bro. It's done. That's it. She gave you the key back. She walked out on the altar. She put Peyton back onto you. She declined your video call. Anything else, Lucas, you're turning into a stalker. It's done.
But I could just use a sign or something to let me know I'm doing okay.
Shit's in the nappy. Oh, that's a sign. I guess that's a sign. I don't know.
Okay.
That's, yeah, Sam.
It's you and me, baby.
What, the baby dies? That'd be kind of depressing. They're not gonna do it. Maybe it's like Game of Thrones or something, but where they're literally dashing babies' heads onto rocks to kill them. A literal scene. Or is it a wall? I forgot what it was. Yo, don't watch this recommendation because it's just the most depressing film ever. But The Nightingale, there's a baby that dies in that, and he's just brutal. It's like, what the fuck? Yeah, anyway, let's move on from babies dying. Even though the show brought it up, it's not me. The show brought this shit up. Yeah, this is a very good episode. I think pretty much every character was pretty good. Quinton was the only one that was a bit like, what are we doing here? Because I thought we were just going to go in a circle, but they kind of brought it back at the end. But like I said in the reaction, that needs to be it. They can't have Quinton be Marty again in the next... God, we only have 2 episodes left, Jesus. So, yeah, I think they've done good with Quinton for this season. But like I say, they can't repeat themselves again, which I thought they were going to do this episode, which they kind of started to, but pulled back. The thing I put down as a positive that I thought might surprise people is I put Maleficent being there for Mouth. Mouth, and I've got no issues with Mouth this episode, which is like, again, I didn't really have that much of an issue with him in the last few episodes. It's just he didn't really do much in those episodes to make me like him. And I still don't like him, let me make that clear. But in terms of story, I think this is the best Mouth has been in about 2.5 seasons. Maybe not that much, but it's been a while. Yeah, their romance is fine. I think they both have chemistry. He's kind of smooth with the teleprompter there, saying that he loves her and stuff. And I think they have chemistry. But I just worry that she's going to leave by the end of the season, or like season 6 starts. And Mal's like, oh yeah, we broke up. So it's on to his next romance. I don't know. We'll see. I hope this is like it and she sticks around kind of thing. Because, yeah, I'm just done with Mouth in general, but him going from romance to romance. Also, side note, where's Rachel? I know she like went, no, she went back to doing a thing, but no one's mentioned her at all. No one's even mentioned Rachel. I feel like they brought back in a few characters, like with Rachel, Chase, even Deb was not existing in this episode, but Deb's fine because that was only in the last episode. And Andy and Karen went back to Ireland, was it? I don't know where they've gone, but they left, so that makes sense. But Rachel and Chase, they've just disappeared. That was weird. Nathan, tripling down on not letting Dan back into their lives. I can't... I feel bad for Dan, but I get it. It's like, I don't know. It's such a tricky one. It's such a tricky one. Like I said, it's not like some little thing Dan did. He didn't just kill Keith as well. Like, he was mentally and physically abusive to Nathan and Lucas their entire lives. Like, he's been a twat. Like I said, he's the best character of the show. But there's no denying that Dan has been evil. Evil. That is if you put aside the him killing Keith. It'd be hard enough, I think, for them to let Dan back into their lives with just that stuff, but having killed Keith, I think, is like the thing. So I do think they will cave at some point, but I don't, maybe not. I don't know. It won't be this season, that's for sure. I think that was like the definitive answer for at least the next couple of episodes as well. So yeah, I don't know where it's gonna go. I don't know. With Dan, he could actually die, and it's just like this depressing story of a man who ruined everything he had. I don't know. I'm very intrigued. That's the most intriguing story for me at the moment, is to see what they do with Dan now and where his character's going to go. Because they could, 6 months, so that's not going to happen in season 5, but let's say season 6, they could go down the road of killing him off. I don't think they will, to be honest, but anything could happen with this show, as we've seen. So yeah, that really enjoyed that story. Not so much in the second half of the episode, but the first half, I put like Brooke and Lucas having scenes together. I think, like I say, that I'm glad they didn't just completely, you know, oh, they're never having scenes together ever again kind of thing, which shows have done, which is strange. But so yeah, glad that was happening. And then the second half, Brooke kind of coming up with a new concept was good stuff. Quinton was, like I say, a 50-50 for me, but I liked that he apologized to Skills and is back on the team. So, and also kind of get Nathan in tire gear of like, we'll train 2 hours a day kind of thing as well. Peyton was a bit eh. I like her working with Haley, but her going to Lindsay was so unnecessary. I get it was her way of being like, oh, you, the book wasn't about it, it's fiction, even though she'd not read the book at all. And I get it was like her trying to like pass the torch. Lindsay has made it so clear that she does not want to be with Lucas at all, like 5 times now. Can we leave her alone? Leave the woman alone. Let her get on with a job and a life, bro. What the fuck? It's getting weird now. It's getting weird. So, yeah, Peyton, strange being. Yeah, I'm just going to go to this person that I don't know and tell her to... What? What? Oh, my God. Leave Lindsay alone. That's what I say. But yeah, this is a very good episode. I'm going to go not quite an 8, but it did have some 8 out of 10 moments, like say with Dan. That was really good stuff. And then some Nathan scenes, some even Lucas kind of going in on Dan, it makes sense. Like I say, I can't even blame him for having that mindset. Like, I have to keep reiterating. It's kind of like you have to remind yourself that he killed Keith. He shot Keith dead. So yeah, I can't even blame any of the characters for acting the way they have. So rating, I'll give the last one a 7. I think it's definitely better than the last episode. I'll go with 7.7 out of 10. I think it's a very good episode. Don't really have that many flaws in it. A couple of Quinn and stuff, but that was really, and the Peyton stuff, but that's really about it. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed. Let me know what you thought of the episode down below in the comments. And if you do want the early and uncle reactions to One Tree Hill, then link to the Patreon page will be in the description and one of the comments down below. And I'll see you next time for the penultimate episode already, episode 17. Until then, take care. Peace.